on. Camera is on. Just share the screen. प्रॉब्लम आ रही है माधुरी। अच्छा ये पीपीटी खुल गई अपनी। Good morning, all the participants. I welcome you again on AICT-sponsored online faculty development program on Essentials of Successful Case-Based Teaching. Today we have with us Dr. Vinay Goyal, and the topic of today's workshop is Case Writing Techniques in Finance. Dr. Goyal is PhD, CA, MBA, and he is an associate professor of accounting and finance. He has completed his FDB from the prestigious IIM Ahmedabad and diploma in IFRS from KPMG. He is a rank holder CA with a PhD in management from Indore. He has worked for 7 years at IIM Raipur and 3 years at Goa Institute of Management, Goa. Dr. Goyal has more than 20 research papers and case publications in the journals of international repute and Ivory Case Publishing. Dr. Goyal has conducted several MBP programs, both online and offline. He has supervised 8 PhD candidates who are providing services in repute academics and industry. So, sir, on behalf of IPS Academy, I welcome you to this AICT-sponsored 2 weeks online faculty development program. And sir, now the session is over to you, sir.
Right, okay, thank you. Thank you. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Right. Right, okay. So, good morning, all the participants. And today we will be talking on case writing techniques, case writing in the area of accounting and finance. In the area of accounting and finance. Now, this is a very, I will say that it's very difficult to talk that what are the techniques, because when you write a case, there are no techniques on the basis of which you can write a case. There are no techniques. And when I say that there are no techniques, that means that the structure, the way you will write the case, or the topic that you will select, or the learning which you want to give to the participant, is what case writing is all about. It's not a scientific writing, basically, which we write in the research paper where you need to have a flow. But it requires a structure, a proper introduction, a proper orientation, and the objective on the basis of which you will write the case. My objective of this session today will be to talk less and discuss more. I will appreciate if you can keep on asking me the questions and talk to me on the various aspects of case writing. How I will try to go in this session is that first I will like to discuss some pointers, some tips based on one article which I will share with you. That what are the various important things that you need to keep in mind for writing a case study. And I again repeat, this is not a scientific writing. This is not a writing which you need to think a lot. You can write case on any topic. So before I move on to the specific pointers, let me discuss first about the type of cases that are written, basically. So, you know, there are various type of cases, but I will just try to be very narrow or at the very macro level if I talk. There are two type of cases which typically can be written. One, we call it as primary cases. Two type of cases which we can write. And at any place, if you have any doubt, please feel free to stop me and ask. So there are two type of case, and not only in finance and accounting, but in any domain of management, education, or any domain, you can have two type of cases. You can have primary cases and you can have secondary cases. Primary case and secondary case. When I say primary case, actually primary case is a case on an actual company. Case on an actual company. And I will share the example of both the type of cases. And my concentration will be on accounting and finance only. So I will share the examples only from the area of accounting and finance. So primary case on an actual company. And secondary case, based on actual company, but written based on data available in public domain. Data available in public domain. So that means you can take the annual report of a company and write the case. You can take the various newspaper articles published on a particular company and write the case. In primary case, you are not taking the information which is publicly available. But in primary case, you are writing a case on actual company by doing the interview of the CEO of the company or taking the data from the particular company which is not available in public domain. And then based on that interaction which you can have with company officials, you write a case. So this is typically a primary case. See, for example, you want to write a case on a private company. Now, sometimes the data of the private company are not available in the public domain. So to write a case on private company, you need to get in touch with the promoters or the directors or the owners of the private company. Or you suppose you want to write a case on an entrepreneur who is a successful entrepreneur, but it is not a company. So in that case, you need to have an interaction with that person. That person will talk to you about various type of data. He will give you various type of information. And based on that information, you will write the case. So in accounting and finance also, you can write the case based on primary data and you can write the case on secondary data. Then there is another classification of case There is another classification of case writing. There is another type of case, another type of classification. There is another type of classification. So some will say it is a case. It is a case study. It is a caselet. caselet. Right. Somebody will say it is a research case. Case research, research case, or case research. Somebody will say it is a field case. Right. So there are various terminologies which are used. Case, case study, caselet, field-based case, research-based case, action-oriented case. Action-oriented case. Right. So you can find that there are various terminologies which are used when it comes to the case writing. Now, please remember, in the contemporary writing system, in the contemporary system of case writing, there is nothing which is very unique or differentiation about all these terms which are written here. The good publishing house, the top publishing house of the world, which publish cases, only differentiate between a case and research case. A research case. So there is some amount of research which is involved, but research case typically is a primary case. Research typically is a primary case. Some will also write on secondary cases and so on and so forth. So the point I'm trying to explain here is that in the contemporary education system, in the contemporary case writing system, you will not find much difference between all these terminologies. Kai books mein, you will find that in several books it is written that caselet is a small thing, case study is a big thing. When you write a long 20 page, it is a case study. When you write a short page, it is a caselet. Theoretically, it may be right. I don't want to comment on those things. But when it comes to publication, when it comes to writing of case, there is no difference between all these terminologies which I am writing here. Everything is same. There is no difference between a case or case study or caselet. Because ultimately, it is the objective of the case that will matter. It will only, the only thing which will matter is the, what is the learning that you are giving to the participant or to the learner for whom you are writing the case, right? So we need not to engross much on whether I am writing a case or whether I am writing a case study or whether I am writing a research case or I am writing a field case or I'm writing action-oriented case. Okay, books may theoretically, articles may, you will find that all these things are written, but in the actual line of thing, when we are targeting a particular case publishing house, this does not matter that what type of case you are writing. The only thing which matters is what is the objective of the case and what is the learning that you will try to give from the case study that we are writing. One of the important thing in case writing that you have to remember, and I will also show you some case writing tools and tips which I am sharing at the later part. So I said that there is another bifurcation which we can do, which is actual case. Actual, so when I use the word actual means real case. And then there are fictional cases. When I say fictional cases, means you are making a story. जब वो fictional case की बात करते हैं, means you are making a story. आप एक story बना रहे हैं. You are making a story. Right. So when you are making a story, that means a hypothetical situation you are creating. You are making a story. You are creating a hypothetical situation. You are creating a hypothetical situation. Now, this case can be good for writing, but let me tell you, these are not publishable. Ye publish nahi hote hai. Publication ke upar we will talk in one of the sessions in the later part of your course, later part of your participation. But please remember, fictional case are not published. Fictional case does not find any place in the publication. The publication you are writing, aap likh sakte hain for your own purpose. For if you are writing a book, in that you can write So fictional cases, but when it comes to good publication houses, when it comes to good or top publication houses, जो केस पब्लिश करते हैं, they will not publish fictional cases. That means our case has to be either actual case, real case. Actual real case can be primary case and secondary case, as I said earlier. It can be primary, it can be secondary. It can be experiential based case also. You have worked in an organization and based on your experience, based on your real experience, you are writing something that also can be published. But one of the most important thing that you have to remember in case writing is that fictional case are not publishable. कोई भी अच्छा publication house fictional case को publish नहीं करेगा. They will not publish that. Right? So this is a basic background of case writing that we are going to start with. So before I move ahead, any doubts, any questions, any clarification, please ask.
Hello, sir, am I audible?
Yeah, audible, please.
Sir, this is Suresh Sharma from IPS Academy, Hyderabad.
Right.
Sir, I have a question, sir.
Right.
Sir, how can frame the open-ended case in the finance and accounting domain? Any agenda for the how framing to? Of how to frame open-ended case studies? Sir, any specific agenda for framing these kinds of the cases, sir, in the finance and accounting domain?
Right. I will come to that. What's your name? I'm sorry, I missed your name.
Suraj Sharma, sir.
Suraj. So I'm just coming to that, Suraji, that how to start the case. What are the various elements that you have to keep in mind for writing a case, especially in the case of finance and accounting. I will also show you various cases that how they are written. I will show you my own cases also. I will show you some cases of other participants, other authors also. And we will try to see that how to start a case, how you can frame a case. Some cases are one page case, some cases are 24 page case. So a case with 24 page will have a different orientation of starting. A case with 2 page will have a different orientation of starting. A primary case will have a different structure. A secondary case which you are writing for from the data which is publicly available from newspaper clippings, from various articles, right? So and this article which now I will be starting, which you must be able to see on my screen, 25 questions to ask as you begin to develop a new case study, right? So this is one of the, and this article I will share with all the participants. Sure. So once I think that I discuss this article, and then in between I will keep on showing you the various case studies published in the top publication houses written, and you will be able to see that how we are starting. And then if you have still have any doubts, you please feel free to come back to me on that.
Sure.
Right. So this is a very very good. I mere paas koi PPT nahi hai. I will be writing, and I will be sharing some PDF files with you. And based on that, Saket ji, dekhiye, jo disguised case hai, secondary data ko aapko disguise karne ki zarurat nahi hoti hai. Right. So and I will request jo bhi in chat box, if somebody is asking the question, you can mark the question to everyone in the meeting, so that when I am answering the question, at least everybody is able to see. So this is the question which Saket ji has asked to me, that disguised and non disguised cases are classified in which category, primary or secondary? Chat box mein likha hua hai. To Saket ji, secondary cases ko disguise karne ki zarurat nahi hoti hai, because it is a public domain mein wo information available hai. In case writing, information is disguised only when you are writing a primary case. Secondary mein to public domain mein hai, usko aapko disguise karne ki zarurat nahi hai. There is nothing to disguise there, right? So you can directly take the information extract. This is, suppose you want to abhi the Supreme Court ne deal ko stop kiya, right? Reliance Industries Limited and Future Group ka deal jo hai, that has been blocked. Now everything is available in the public domain for management learning in mergers and acquisition. फाइनेंस में आई होप मोस्ट ऑफ द पार्टिसिपेंट्स हियर आर फ्रॉम फाइनेंस एंड अकाउंटिंग एरिया. सो रिलायंस इंडस्ट्रीज लिमिटेड वांटेड टू एक्वायर फ्यूचर और उनका जो भी डीलिंग हुआ, बट अल्टीमेटली अमेज़न स्टेप्ड इनटू इट एंड द डील हैज स्टॉप्ड. सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने अभी उस पर स्टे दे दिया है. द पॉइंट व्हिच आई वांट टू एक्सप्लेन इन दिस पर्टिकुलर एग्जांपल इज दैट यू कैन यूज द नेम ऑफ रिलायंस इंडस्ट्रीज लिमिटेड and you can use the name of future, you can use the name of Supreme Court of India, you can use the name of Amazon, because you are extracting the information from various sources. The most important point that you have to remember when you are writing secondary cases and not disguising the name is that the source has to be very clear. Ekdam authentic, any website which you are writing. So in the case at the end, and I will show you some sources, that in some cases that how you are writing those sources. So in secondary, you need not to disguise. In primary, the problem is that the company who is giving you the information can say that don't use our name, use some XYZ name, right? So when the company is giving us the information which is not available in public domain, then you have to write the case in the disguised form. Jahan par hum name ko disguise kar dete hain, where we disguise the name and so on and so forth, right? So I hope, Saket ji, I am able to explain you that perspective. Right. Any other doubts, questions? Please feel free to unmute yourself and ask me at any point of time, because if we are here for 4-5 hours, you cannot conduct the session if you will not ask the question. Yadi main lagatar bolta rahunga to aap bhi, you will also feel frustrated and the session will not be interactive. So here I'm starting my topic. Vasiullah ji, if I'm able to understand your question correctly, which you have written in the chat box, that if you are using the secondary information and the source has been quoted, there are no legal implications. There are no legal implication, right? Uske legal implication nahi hote hain. If it is secondary cases, I hope it's a one line answer, but it is a very clear answer that if you are using the source, they say, let me show you, I'll go show you, and then Ishika ji, then I will answer your question. So, you know, this question which Vasiullah ji has asked, that will there be any legal problems? So let me go to the browser. So I hope you are able to see my browser. And let me write Reliance Future Group. Reliance Future Group deal. So here you can say Reliance Future Group deal, and there is the Economic Times article which is written here. And then they have written something about Reliance Future Group deal. And this website which I am taking into consideration, is, you can see the website which I'm taking into consideration is Economic Times. Now, if I write something, say I will write this line, I will take this line, and then I will frame it in my own language, and I will write that as per Economic Times, the hearing of appeal, blah, 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 whatever I want to write, I will write that. Right. So the point is there any legal implication of this in my academic writing? There is no legal implication of this in your legal writing. Legal writing mein isme koi fark nahi padega. There will be no legal implication. Ishika ji, case ko jab aap disguise karte hain, to aap company ke letterhead par approval lete hain, which you have to submit it to the publication house. Right. So suppose I am writing a case on a company. जैसे मैं आपको एक एग्जांपल देता हूं, अभी एक लेटेस्ट केस स्टडी पब्लिश हुई है, राइट? अब जैसे आपने कंपनी का नाम सुना होगा, बॉम्बे शेविंग कंपनी, राइट? नाउ आई एम शोइंग यू दैट. सो दिस इज अ केस रेडी, एक इंडियन ऑथर ने अभी 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 ये पब्लिश हुआ है रिसेंटली, तो ये देख सकते हैं आप, बॉम्बे शेविंग कंपनी, राइट, जुलाई 2021 में पब्लिश हुआ है. नाउ दिस इज एन एक्चुअल कंपनी. अब सपोज the owner of this company has given the permission to use the name, but if suppose the owner of the company will not give the permission, then on his letterhead he will write, on original letterhead of Bombay Shaving Company, that I am giving the permission to write the case, but I am not allowing to use the name Bombay Shaving Company. The author will be using some other name, so say XYZ ABC Shaving Company or something. But actual name, तो कई बार they want that actual name मत लीजिए. But sorry, but the publishing house, so this is Harvard Publishing, which is one of the leading publish, which is one of the best publication house in the world. They will not publish the case unless and until they get the original letter from the company that they have given the permission to write. So it is not the disguise does not mean, disguise ka meaning ye nahi hota hai ki aapne case ko aapne actual company ke name, the disguise meaning is you have just hidden the name of the actual company, but facts are original, facts disguise nahi hai. That is the meaning, Ishika ji. I hope I am able to make it clear. Right. So how to write a case study in finance? So that's the article which I started with, that how do you start the case, how do you write the case study, how do you structure the case. And to be honest and clear, please remember, it is up to you that how you write the case study. Aapke upar hai ki aap case study kaise likhte hain. I am just giving you an idea, but I will give you several examples that how different authors have actually used different type of case studies which are written. Right, so let me move on. Yes, Srinivas, I'm coming to that. Okay, how to start, what are the aspects you have to consider for the case study, that is what I am coming to. Now, the first thing that you have to remember, and 25 questions to ask before you begin to develop a new case study. And I believe that once you answer these 25 questions, isme kai questions repeat bhi hain, there are some questions which are repeating also. But once you will be able to answer these 25 questions, you will be able to structure your case study in a proper way. The first question, so you can see, good case studies are diverse as the faculty and researchers who write them. The following checklist was prepared to assist first-time case writers. Its purpose is to stimulate thought and suggest ideas rather than to offer hard and fast rules. So I repeat, aap duniya mein koi bhi case writing ka article padhenge, you will read any article, they only say that this is the suggestion, this is not the rule. Because at the end of the day, it is up to you that how you want to write the case study. It is up to you, I repeat, it is up to you that how you want to write the case study. The first question which is asked here is, and please feel free to stop me. So where will this case fit within the existing course syllabus? What cases will precede and follow it? And what learning objective should it eliminate? So this is the first part of case writing which I am starting with. And the first part is a very important part, that what is the objective of the case study. So let me come to my whiteboard. I hope you are able to see my whiteboard. The first thing that you have to remember in case writing, jaise hi aap case writing ke bare mein sochna shuru karte hain, so as soon as you start thinking about case writing in accounting and finance or any domain, again I repeat, the first thing that you have to see is which subject and what is the objective. A finance and accounting is a big domain. Say for example, which subjects. So yadi main ek list banana shuru karun ki what are the subject of finance and accounting, so whether you are writing a course on financial accounting, whether you want to write the case on financial accounting, whether you want to write the case on cost accounting, whether you want to write a case on management accounting, whether you want to write a case on financial management, whether you want to write a case on mergers and acquisition, whether you want to write a case on derivatives, whether you want to write a case on security analysis and portfolio management, SAPM, whether you want to write a case on valuation, whether you want to write a case on, you know, mergers, acquisitions, valuations, whether you want to write a case on PE, whether you want to write a case on venture capital, whether you want to write a case on investment banking, whether you want to write a case on commercial banking, right? आप देखिए, whether you want to write a case on fixed income securities, whether you want to write a case on behavioral finance, whether you, so, और ये तो this list can go on. मतलब इतने सब्जेक्ट्स हैं फाइनेंस में कि यू कैन नॉट इमेजिन द नंबर ऑफ सब्जेक्ट्स. और 40-50 सब्जेक्ट्स हैं. सो द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई इज विच सब्जेक्ट. द केस हैज टू बी स्पेसिफिक. द केस कैन नॉट बी इन अकाउंटिंग और फाइनेंस में. यू आर नॉट हियर, यू आर नॉट टीचिंग मार्केटिंग और स्ट्रेटजी. कई बार अकाउंटिंग एंड फाइनेंस में द केसेस आर क्लोज्ड एंडेड केसेस. Right, so if you are writing a case on balance sheet, ultimately at the end of the day, balance sheet has to match. So it is a closed-ended case. So what I'm trying to say here is that the first thing which you have to decide is which subject, what expertise you have. Then in subject, you have to go to micro level, topic. कौन से topic पर लिखना चाहते हैं? तो फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग में ऑन व्हाट टॉपिक यू वांट टू राइट, कॉस्ट अकाउंटिंग में ऑन व्हिच टॉपिक यू वांट टू राइट, मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटिंग में ऑन व्हिच टॉपिक यू वांट टू राइट, फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट में ऑन व्हिच टॉपिक. जैसे फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट में बहुत सारे केसेस होते हैं. तो इफ आई वांट टू टेक, लेट मी टेक अ सब्जेक्ट, क्या आई वांट टू राइट अ केस ऑन फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट. फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट में वेदर आई वांट टू राइट अ केस ऑन बैक, वेटेड एवरेज कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल, whether I want to write a case on capital structure, whether I want to write a case on capital budgeting, whether I want to write a case on dividend policy. Then in VAC, what is my objective? In capital structure, what is my objective? In capital budgeting, whether I want to have a case on IRR or NPV or what? Dividend policy, what should be my dividend policy? So now I'm coming to micro level. So maine pehle subject decide kiya, the first thing, first step. Once I decided the subject, second step is go to the micro level of that. Aur third step mein yadi aapko aur bhi micro level par jana hai, to aur micro level par jaiye. Jaise VAC mein, VAC में अलग से यू कैन राइट अ केस ऑन कॉस्ट ऑफ इक्विटी. मैं कॉस्ट ऑफ इक्विटी पर एक पूरा केस लिख सकता हूं. व्हाई? सो कौन सी मेथड यूज करना, वेदर कॉस्ट ऑफ इक्विटी के लिए शैल आई यूज दी डिविडेंड अर्निंग यील्ड मेथड और आरओई मेथड और कैपिटल एसेट प्राइसिंग मॉडल मेथड, विच मेथड टू बी यूज्ड. सो मेथड के ऊपर मैंने एक केस लिख दिया. सो द पॉइंट इज, द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट यू हैव टू डिसाइड इज दिस. The first thing you have, that you have to decide is this. Case का structure जो है, case को कैसे frame करना, वो तो secondary step पर आता है. वो तो आप आराम से वो तो आप एक structure, तो मैं आपको अभी कई structures बताऊंगा. I will show you various structures, but before showing you the structure, the first step that you have to take is on what topic I want to write the case study. What should be the topic? What should be the exact course in which this case will be taught? Whether I will be teaching. आप आपका केस मल्टीपल कोर्सेज में आप टीच कर सकते हैं. मैं कभी भी ये नहीं कहता कि your case cannot be taught in one course. You can have the case frame ki ये इस कोर्स में भी फिट हो सकता है, इस कोर्स में भी फिट हो सकता है, right? जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल आई एम राइटिंग अ केस दिस डेज ऑन से बैंकिंग एनालिसिस ऑफ बैलेंस शीट ऑफ बैंक्स. सो व्हेन आई एम डूइंग द एनालिसिस ऑफ बैलेंस शीट ऑफ बैंक्स, इट कैन बी टॉट इन अ फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग कोर्स, इट कैन बी टॉट इन अ फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट एनालिसिस कोर्स, इट कैन बी टॉट इन अ बैंकिंग कोर्स, राइट? सो द फर्स्ट थिंग यू हैव टू डिसाइड इज विच सब्जेक्ट यू विल बी टीचिंग. कौन सा सब्जेक्ट आप इसको आप लेंगे जिसमें इस कोर्स इस केस को पढ़ाएंगे. What is the objective? The objective second aayega. So first is which subject, jo humne yahan par likha hai. So which subject the case will come. This is, sorry. Yeah, which subject. And then in that subject, what is the topic of the case? Aur topic se matlab case ka heading topic ki baat nahi kar raha hu main. In that subject, which topic? Right? So that is how the case beginning starts. And then any questions in this? any questions, any clarification on subject, topic? Let me, main aapko dikhata hun. You can see here. Again, if I go back to this so you now you can see here just a finance hai yahan par, just a sec. I hope you are able to see my browser, right? To aap ye dekh sakte hain jaise yahan par ye disciplines hain. So if I am clicking here the discipline of finance, so here you can see these are the various subheadings in finance which they have. View all topics if I do, and these are individual topics. So if I'm showing you all topics here, you can see these are the subjects: accounting, asset management, banks and banking, behavioral finance, budgets and budgeting, capital structure, corporate finance, credit and loans, financial analysis, financial engineering, financial negotiations, financial risk, fintech, international finance, investment management, personal finance. And when you will go inside this accounting maybe, so then you will find that there are accounting ke aa gaye, accounting methods, accounting procedures, accounting standards, annual reports, auditing, balance sheet, bookkeeping, costing, equity method, financial statement, management accounting, management control, tax accounting, variance analysis. Right? So you will find that unless and until you decide in case writing, unless and until you decide that this is my case, this is the case I want to write, on this topic I want to write, and this topic will be suitable, and this is the learning which I want to give. That is the objective which I am coming to the next part. Yes, Vasimulaji, there are real cases with secondary information. Real cases hote hain, secondary information se aapke real cases bahut sare bante hain. Jaise main aapko idhar dikhata hu, let me show you. Jaise ki mere colleague ne case likha hai, IndusInd Bank. ठीक है, तो यर यू कैन सी दिस इज आई होप यू आर एबल टू सी माय ब्राउज़र. अब ये इंडसइंड बैंक रेसिडुअल इनकम वैल्यूएशन, ये वैल्यूएशन के ऊपर केस है, राइट? रेसिडुअल इनकम वैल्यूएशन, आई होप यू आर एबल टू सी दिस. ये सेकेंडरी डाटा के ऊपर केस है पूरा, देयर इज नो प्राइमरी डाटा यूज्ड इन दिस. और इन्होंने बैंक की बैलेंस शीट लिया, उसका बैंक का वैल्यूएशन किया यूजिंग दिस मेथड कॉल्ड residual income valuation. This is a method of valuation. So it's a fairly simple case. So yadi aap ye case dekhe, so this is the case. You can see here ek 7 page ka chota sa case hai, residual income valuation. Aur ye inhone ye Indian banking industry ko ye sab secondary data hai, और ये देखिए इन्होंने ये कोट लिखे हैं, कहां से ये डाटा लिया, बिजनेस टुडे से डाटा लिया, तो नीचे रेफरेंस लिखा है, ये सब रेफरेंस लिखे हैं, ये ध्रुवी सुब्बाराव बैंक स्ट्रक्चर इन इंडिया, रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया, ये इस डेट पर, राइट। सो और ये डेट इंपॉर्टेंट होती है कि किस डेट को आपने लिखा, ये तो खैर राइटिंग में ये मैं अभी आऊंगा। जब आप रेफरेंस लिखते हैं और खासतौर से व्हेन यू टेक द रेफरेंस फ्रॉम द इंटरनेट, यू हैव टू राइट द डेट एंड डेट कि किस डेट को आपने वो देखा, क्योंकि सपोज आर्काइव में चला गया बाद में, सो यू कैन क्लेम दैट ऑन दिस डेट ये अवेलेबल था, ऑन दिस डेट दिस हैज नॉट गॉन इनटू द आर्काइव्स, राइट। सो दिस इज हाउ यू बेसिकली टेक दिस इनटू कंसीडरेशन, इंडसइंड बैंक। सो ये इंडसइंड बैंक और ये बिजनेस मिक्स, फाइनेंशियल परफॉर्मेंस, और ये एग्जिबिट इन्होंने ये स्टॉक प्राइस और ये देखिए याहू फाइनेंस से इन्होंने लिया, और ये स्टैटिस्टिक्स रिलेटेड टू इंडियन कमर्शियल बैंक्स, तो ये स्टैटिस्टिक्स कहाँ से लिया उसका रेफरेंस लिखा, ये इंडसइंड बैंक की डाटा कहाँ से लिए वो इन्होंने लिखा है, और ये इनका बैलेंस शीट, तो ये नोट आरबीआई एनपी और ये सोर्स अकॉर्ड फिनटेक से ये डाटा लिया है, एंड देन ये इंडसइंड बैंक का बैलेंस शीट है, और हर जगह रेफरेंस हैज बीन रिटन। तो ये जो पब्लिश हुआ है, दिस केस ये जो लिखा है इंडसइंड बैंक वैल्यूएशन का, दिस इज कंप्लीटली ऑन द सेकेंडरी डाटा, सो दिस इज अ रियल केस, सेकेंडरी डाटा, नेम नॉट डिस्गाइज्ड, कोई डिस्गाइज नहीं है नेम यहां पर, इंडसइंड बैंक के नाम से केस पब्लिश हुआ है। आई होप आई एम एबल टू हेल्प यू देयर। जैसे स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया के बहुत सारे केस पब्लिश हुए हैं, स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया आप देखेंगे तो यू नो हियर यू कैन सी स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग अ स्टेट ओन्ड जायंट, ये सब सेकेंडरी डाटा पर केसेस है, रिवाइटलाइजिंग स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया, और ये श्रीकांत, ये नाउ यू कैन सी ये सेकेंडरी डाटा पर दिस केस हैज बीन रिटन बाय श्रीकांत दातार, ये भी हार्वर्ड के डायरेक्टर है, ऋषिकेश कृष्णन ही इज द डायरेक्टर आई एम बैंगलोर, राइट। सो यू कैन जस्ट इमेजिन, तो यू कैन यूज द सेकेंडरी डाटा, यू कैन यूज द सेकेंडरी डाटा एंड बेस्ड ऑन द सेकेंडरी डाटा, और ये स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया के ऊपर इतने केस लिखे हुए हैं आप देख सकते हैं, राइट। सो दैट इज हाउ यू हैव टू ऑलवेज बिलीव दैट केसेस कैन बी रिटन बेस्ड ऑन द सेकेंडरी डाटा एंड यू नीड नॉट टू डिस्गाइज द नेम, एंड दीज आर रियल केसेस व्हिच आर रिटन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सेकेंडरी डाटा। आई होप आई एम एबल टू आंसर दैट, एनी क्वेश्चंस टू एनीवन, any doubts, any questions, any quick clarification? I hope you are able to see my whiteboard. Now the second thing which I categorically said, so I said that the first step, there are two things which you have to choose, what is the subject, and in that subject what will be the topic. And the next most important point is, what is the objective of your case? What is the objective of your case? What is the objective of your case? And when I use the word objective, that means my learning objective. What is the learning objective which I want my participant to learn from that? What is the learning objective that I want my participant to get from that case? So again, coming back to say this slide, so I'm saying that, okay, I will be writing, so let me make a new slide only. So I'm deciding that I will write a case in financial management. In financial management, I have decided that I will write a case on cost of equity. And in cost of equity, my objective is, so this is my subject, this is my subject, this is my topic, and this is my objective. So what is my objective? So my objective is to make a learner understand various aspect of cost of equity computation. ठीक है, तो इसका मैं एग्जाम्पल लेता हूं. सपोज आई वॉन्ट टू यू, आई होप आप फाइनेंस के प्रोफेसर ये मॉडल जानते होंगे, कैपिटल एसेट प्राइसिंग मॉडल, विच इज रिस्क फ्री रेट प्लस बीटा इन टू आर एम माइनस आर एफ. राइट right? सो मैं इस केस को मैं मेरा ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या है कि कॉस्ट ऑफ इक्विटी के सारे कंपोनेंट लेना. तो कैपम मॉडल ले लिया मैंने, मैंने डिविडेंड ग्रोथ मॉडल ले लिया. आई टेक अनदर मॉडल विच इज डिविडेंड ग्रोथ मॉडल. डिविडेंड ग्रोथ मॉडल का फॉर्मूला होता है डी वन अपॉन पी जीरो इंटू 100 प्लस द ग्रोथ रेट. राइट, सो आई विल टेक दिस मॉडल. अब इन मॉडल्स में आई विल गो टू द माइक्रो लेवल. What is risk-free rate? Risk-free rate कहाँ से लेंगे? तो मैं risk-free rate के various जहाँ जहाँ भी available होती है risk-free rate वो दिखाऊंगा. फिर मैं दिखाऊंगा beta कि beta कैसे calculate होता है, published beta क्या होता है, what are the various type of beta. Then I will tell that what is the market risk, market return. और ये दोनों को मिलाकर हम market risk premium कहते हैं. तो what exactly we mean by market risk premium and so on and so forth. So this is, now you can see that my case objective has been framed. So मैंने topic decide, मैंने subject decide कर लिया, मैंने topic decide कर लिया, मेरा objective decide हो गया. This is how the first step, this is what is the first thing that I will take into consideration while writing the case. Any doubts, any questions to anyone? And then I will come to the second question from that.
Sir,
yes, please go ahead.
Sir, do we have any specific structure like in projects we have, right? Or in PhD thesis, like first chapter introduction, review of right. literature, like that. Like, do we have any structure for
no.
to write this case?
Sir? No, we don't have any structure.
And some minimum stipulated words or pages like that.
Now see, I will discuss the. I will be taking a session in the next week on case publishing.
Okay.
I will take that session on case publishing, and in that case publishing, I will tell you that how many pages you need, minimum kitna hota hai, maximum kitna hota hai, kahan publish kar sakte hain. So as far as the length of the case is concerned, it is always open. It is not very rigid. But still, we need to keep some caution in our mind, and that I will discuss definitely in the next class. Right? That as far as structure is concerned, this is a continuous question which is coming, and my answer to this is continuously same. That there is no fixed structure. There is no fixed structure. मैं इसमें ही एक question पर पहले चले जाता हूँ because there have been lot of question. Let me,
So one.
Here it is. Just a sec. I'll just give you the answer. Now here you can see this 14th question. I hope everybody is able to see this 14th question. What are the standard components of a case study? Right. Now this is the standard component. That's it. So. Even in top case study, you will find that there is an opening paragraph, and I will discuss this opening paragraph in detail. That opening paragraph kya hota hai, because this is where the heart of the case will lie, opening paragraph. So your opening paragraph should be very powerful. Then the background and context, case actors, industry, blah, blah, blah. And then the whole story of the case. And then finally the conclusion. So There is no fixed structure. अब ये यदि एक पेज का केस है तो you have to frame on that basis. यदि ये छह पेज का केस है तो it will extend, something will extend. If it is a case study of, if it is a case of 50 page, 20 page, then the things will be different. So I again repeat that there is not much which we can think about the structure of the case, because you can publish any type of cases. Just keep something in mind that is there any learning or the some concrete learning which you are able to give to the reader of that case. That's the only thing. कई लोग जो है वो newspaper के एक मैं आपको case दिखाता हूँ. I'll just show you a case. I hope most of you.
Vinay sir, sorry to interrupt in between. Sir, can you please share this 25 questions on the chat box as a PDF, sir?
I'll do that.
So that everybody will be having this, and in that case, if someone wants to refer and...
Yes, 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 I'll do that.
Thank you so much.
Now, you see, there is one case which I am opening here. Abhi case, I hope you are able to see my browser. I hope you are able to see my browser.
Yes, sir.
Right. So, this is statements of cash flow, three examples. Aur isme inhone kuch nahi kiya hai. Now, just see that how they have written the case. Or statement of cash flow, three examples. So, kuch students baat kar rahe hain. Some students are talking. And one student does not know about cash flow. The other student knows something about cash flow. That means the student was absent in the class. So this one student is explaining the other student the various element of cash flow. And then the assignment is given. The assignment is given. And three cash flow statements are given of three companies. And then based on these questions, you have to answer. Based on these questions, you have to answer. This is a closed-ended case. Open questions are directly given. So now there is nothing in this case. इन्होंने तीन company उठा लिया, तीनों के नाम disguise कर दिए. They are not using the actual name, but if you are using the actual name also of the company from the secondary data, no problems. दो student की बातचीत दिखा दिया, cash flow को explain कर दिया. और फिर क्वेश्चंस कर लिए कि आंसर दिस क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द बेसिस ऑफ कैश फ्लो. नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी, अब ये स्ट्रक्चर आपको कहीं भी देखने को नहीं मिलेगा. नो थ्योरी इन द वर्ल्ड विल से दैट यू कैन राइट द केस स्टडी. सो दिस इज एन ओपनिंग पैराग्राफ व्हिच इंट्रोड्यूसेस द केस. फिर एक मीटिंग दिखा दिया दो स्टूडेंट का, और फिर क्वेश्चंस दे दिया, असाइनमेंट दे दिया, स्टोरी दे दिया और एग्जिबिट डाल दिया. देयर इज नथिंग एडिशनल व्हिच हैज बीन डन हियर. एंड दिस इज हाउ यू कैन सी दैट अ वेरी सिंपल केस स्टडी हैज बीन रिटन. Right. I hope. You can ask further questions.
Sir, like for research articles, how we have ISN and ISBN. For these case study publications also, we'll have like that.
So, case study, you do not have any numbers. Case study, you have that which publication house you have published the case. The credibility comes when the case is published with a top publication house. There are case journals also in which you can publish your case. There are repositories also where you can publish your case. But research paper citations or something, case study does not have that type of perspective. Case study normally have a different type of perspective. Case study have how many cases are sold, which is the publication house that has published the case. And unfortunately, in the Indian education system, case study is not given preference when it comes to ranking of the institute or an IRF ranking. Case study is basically self. It gives you a self-satisfaction that you have written something which is being taught across the world by various professors. Because if you publish the case in a good publication house, you have only satisfaction. That is how I can put it. So yes, Jayasri has written a question to me. Does research paper have more weightage or case study? Academically, research paper will have more weightage. Academically, research paper have more weightage. I hope, Jayasri.
Thank you so much, sir.
And others, I'm able to answer this.
Sir,
yeah, please go ahead.
Sir, in this case study, there is no need to require any kinds of the literature review, research methodology.
No. There is nothing. It is just. Please understand. You are just trying to give a basic understanding or basic knowledge on a particular topic to the students. Your objective is learning.
Yeah. Thanks. Thank you so much.
I have shared this PDF file on chat box. You can download and you can keep on referring because I am discussing this file. I have shared this file on the chat box. I hope you can, you are able to see on the chat box this file I have.
No, sir, it's not there on chat.
Yes, sir, it's not here in the chat box.
Check it.
Yes, now received. Now received, Vanessa.
Yes, Ishika. That's what I'm trying to say. You can do that. You can do that. Right? So Ishika, you can download that case, you can read that case, and you can use that methodology and you can write a case on some other enterprise for the purpose of publication.
Sir, sorry to interrupt, sir, but this file is not in the chat box, sir.
Ma'am,
is it not there?
Ma'am, the file is Jayashree, ma'am, the file is there in the chat box. Not to worry, I'm sharing it on WhatsApp group as well, ma'am.
Okay. The thing is, I am not able to see.
No problem, ma'am. I'm just sharing it in the WhatsApp group, ma'am.
Thank you.
Okay, ma'am.
Right. So moving on. So here you can see the first question, which I have addressed, and I have spent some time on first question because this is the most important question that we have to answer. Once you decide the subject, once you decide the topic, then automatically the second question which is written here is answered. Right? Who is your audience? Now, why we think about the audience, let me just give you a short discussion on this, that who will the audience be? First year student or second year students or executive education program, MDP, how much familiarity they should have, what issues are most on their minds. Why you need to think about audiences, that suppose I am writing a case on basic finance, then that case may not be used in the advanced finance courses. Or if I'm writing a case on merger and acquisition, then a case on merger and acquisition A case on merger and acquisition will basically cannot be taught to the first year students, because during their first year, they are not aware of anything about basics of finance. So the important point that you have to remember in this first and second point is when you are deciding the subject, when you are deciding the topic, when you are deciding that where it will fit in my course, when you are deciding that what is the objective of this course, you have to always think of who is your audience. Kiske liye aap likh rahe hain? For whom you are writing the case. So you are writing the case for first year students, second year students, for executive students or PhD students, and so on and so forth. So keep in mind that, yes, I'm writing the case for this particular audience. I'm writing the case for first year accounting students. I'm writing the case for second year corporate finance student. I'm writing the case for second year specialization finance student. I'm writing the case for minor finance student, and so on and so forth. Jab tak ye clarity aapko nahi aayegi, aap case nahi likh sakte. You cannot write case study unless and until you are very clear on these first two questions. So I hope I'm able to clarify the first step of case writing. That is, what are the two things that how to start the case. So structure of the case I will definitely come at the later part. But first we are thinking about how to develop a case study. So first the development happens and then the writing part comes. So you know that. So the example which I have taken here, I can show you that example again. So here you can see the example which I have taken. Let me take another example here. Suppose I want to write a case study. I will show you one of my cases. 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 I will show you one of my cases and this I wrote a case. मैं आपको वो केस दिखाता हूँ. So subject. So I took the subject as financial accounting. I took the subject as financial statement analysis, and I thought that it will be helpful in banking also. ठीक है, तो ये हमने तीन सब्जेक्ट को लिया एंड और इसमें सब्जेक्ट में हमारा टॉपिक था रेशियो एनालिसिस और एनालिसिस ऑफ फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स. तो दिस वाज माय टॉपिक. तो ये दिस वाज माय सब्जेक्ट, दिस वाज द सब्जेक्ट एट माइक्रो लेवल, दिस वाज माय टॉपिक, right? So and my objective was, and the third thing was my objective, and my objective in writing that case study was all type of financial analysis, all type of analysis or banking. इसलिए कि loan sanctioning दो objective हमने उसमें रखे. Let me show you this case. इस case the case is, the name of the case is Anandam Manufacturing Company. So let me show you this case and just think the objectives. So my subject is financial accounting, financial statement analysis, banking. My topic is analysis of financial statements, and my objective is the analysis, all the type of analysis of financial statement, and then based on the financial analysis, it will be decided that whether the loan will be sanctioned or not. So let me show you this case. Here you can see I am writing Anandam Manufacturing Company. So here it is, Anandam Manufacturing Company, and the heading of this case. And you can see this is one of the best seller cases in the world, right? This is ये दुनिया में सबसे ज़्यादा बिकता है ये केस. So Anandam Manufacturing Company, analysis of financial statements. So this is myself and my colleague wrote this case. So and in July 2015, this Anandam is an actual company. It is a primary case. It's a private company. And just see that in July 2015, the owner of Anandam approached the bank for additional funding to meet the growing requirements. The owner was confident about the financial prospects of the firm, with its fourfold increase in revenue and phenomenal increase in profit over the last 3 years. In a lengthy discussion with the manager, the owner shared the development of his company and the dynamic. He believed his firm was performing strongly in the highly competitive industrial environment. The bank manager instructed the loan officer to process the loan application as soon as possible and make a decision. And determining the health of the company would involve preparing a trend analysis, and see here, yahan par accounting shuru ho gaya. Trend analysis, common size statement, interpreting selecting ratios, and statement of cash flow. And was the Anandam a good, based on this analysis, was Anandam a good candidate for receiving a loan? And then the learning objective. To ye dekhiye, objective likha hai. The case is suitable for early stage of an MBA or undergraduate course in accounting, where students are required to study the financial analysis of an organization. It is also relevant in bank management course, where the approval or rejection of loan is taught. The case requires students to conduct a financial analysis of the Anandam company for the purpose of obtaining a loan from the bank. The case will help demonstrate shortcomings in the ratio analysis and will serve as a caution to student against misleading and misrepresenting the financial statements. So ye 6 page ka case hai, and here you can see. So yeah, there is a, so this is the, so that was the summary of the case, and now this case is written, Anandam Manufacturing, and you know, so this is a garment company. So humne Indian garment manufacturing ko likha, ye main process aapko abhi bataunga. So here you can see, and then financial, then future prospectus, aur ye inka exhibits, chhota sa case hai. But it is one of the best cases which is available in the market. So right, so I hope you are able to relate this to what I was trying to explain to you when you decide about that, what is the topic of the, what is the subject that you are writing, what is the topic you are deciding, who is your target audience, to whom you want that case to be referred to, who will be reading that case, who will be analyzing that case, and whether the level when they will be analyzing the case, what should be the level of the students, and so on and so forth. So I hope I am able to give you the answers which the earlier participants were also asking. So any questions, any doubts, please ask.
Sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, do we have any repositories, sir, for these case studies, like we have for the research paper, Google Scholar, and
yes. So case publishing repositories, today I will not discuss anything. I will discuss that in the next class. I think on 16th, 17th, I have that class. So I will discuss on that where are the repositories and where you will get the credibility, means where to publish so that you get the credibility of your case. At least it is considered as an authentic case.
Yes. Yes.
Hello.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Sir, this is open-ended case study, no? Anandam case studies.
Yeah, it is both the closed-ended and the open-ended case study, because the calculation that you will do will result in the same answers.
Same answers. Okay,
so if you will prepare the cash flow, if you will calculate the ratios, the answer will be same. But the decision that you will take will differ.
Yeah,
so one bank manager can think that these are good ratios and I can sanction them. Another bank manager can think that no, these are not good ratios or not, performance is not good, and hence I should not sanction them. So it's based on the policy of the bank. Just say aapko CIBIL score pata hoga. So CIBIL score mein some banks 750 per credit card issue kar deta hai. Some banks will not issue credit card on 750 score. They need 800 score.
Thanks.
So it's like a score. Aap ek score calculate kar rahe hai. And based on that score, whether the sanction will be done or not. So that is how it matters. Any other doubts, questions, clarifications in the first part which I have discussed? Right. Now the third one is a very important point. How fresh is the case topic? Ab ye thoda sa ek dicey question hai. How fresh is the topic? I hope you are able to see my. So how fresh is the topic? Just a second. So the third one is, how fresh is the case topic? Are you able to see my screen?
No, sir.
Yes, sir, it is visible.
So the next question that you have to answer is, how fresh is the case topic? Now, this is a very, very dicey question. And why this is a very dicey question? Because there are some topics which are very, very relevant. And there are some topics which are very, which always works. There are some topics which works only in some specific situation. But how to decide that whether this topic is a fresh topic and whether the students will have a learning on this? So there are no set rules. There are no set rules on the basis of which you can decide that which topic is the fresh topic. Let me take an example, jo bhi presently chal raha hai. So, you know, the present pandemic, COVID situation, which is presently going on, jo abhi COVID chal raha hai. So there are a lot of cases which are being submitted to the publication houses, highlighting that in COVID, aisa ho gaya, in COVID, merger and acquisition ho gaya, in COVID, the valuation of the company went down. And the good publication houses or good repositories are not interested in, so whenever you write the word COVID, they will not publish. So one of the student, one of my colleague asked me ki COVID se publish nahi ho raha hai, what to do? So I said that instead of using the word COVID, use the word pandemic. Because COVID ho sakta hai, aaj aake, today it is there and tomorrow it is not there. But pandemic is a situation that can happen anytime. Kabhi bhi aa sakta hai. Today it is COVID, tomorrow it can. So what I'm trying to say is that when you write a case, choice of word, choice of topic, and the freshness of topic, that how many years that topic will be fresh, right? How many years that topic will be fresh? And that is what is written here. If you see these two points which are written, how fresh is the topic? Historical cases are often difficult to write because actors have changed and details are not accessible. And on the other hand, cases in process, that is the present problems with, so cases which are having present problems, which are having objectivity, which are having some perspective, which are having some confidentiality, which you can bring, which the students will try to come up when they are reading the case. That type of cases are always taken as the fresh cases, and they are always taken as the cases which can be published. So your topic should be, and fresh topic does not mean that whether it's a new topic or an old topic. You say accounting a balance sheet is a topic of 100 years old. तो आप उसको ये नहीं बोल सकते कि इट इज अ ओल्ड टॉपिक. बैलेंस शीट इज अ टॉपिक जिसमें केसेस हमेशा आप लिख सकते हैं. यू कैन राइट केसेस एनी टाइम. इन मर्जर्स एंड एक्विजिशंस रीस्ट्रक्चरिंग यू कैन राइट केसेस एनी टाइम. अगेन मर्जर एंड एक्विजिशन टॉपिक बहुत पुराना है, बट डज दैट मीन दैट यू कैन नॉट राइट केसेस ऑन दैट? यू कैन राइट थाउजेंड्स ऑफ केसेस ऑन दैट. ये कभी भी हमेशा फाइनेंस में हम हमेशा पढ़ाएंगे. अकाउंटिंग में वी विल ऑलवेज टीच सच टाइप ऑफ टॉपिक्स. सो फ्रेशनेस डज नॉट मीन दैट एकदम मैंने कोविड इज अ फ्रेश. सो कोविड फॉर मी कोविड इज नॉट अ फ्रेश टॉपिक बिकॉज कोविड आज है कल नहीं रहेगा, तो ये कल पुराना हो जाएगा. फ्रेश का मीनिंग यहां पर ये है, द मीनिंग ऑफ फ्रेश हियर इज दैट आफ्टर 7 years इफ समबडी इज टीचिंग माय केस एट दैट टाइम दैट केस शुड लुक फ्रेश. दैट इज व्हाट इज द मीनिंग. ये भी मैंने आपको एक केस दिखाया था, स्टेटमेंट ऑफ कैश फ्लो 3 examples जो मैंने दिखाया था. ये केस हम बहुत पढ़ाते हैं, यू नो ये वाला केस. This case, statement of cash flow 3 examples. आप देखिए ये कब लिखा है केस, 1998, 23 years old case. And I can tell you that this case is taught in most of the B schools in the world. आज भी पढ़ाते हैं इस केस को. और हर साल मतलब thousands of professors are teaching this case everywhere. And what is the reason? The statement of cash flow is a fresh example. Is a fresh topic. आज भी relevant है. So when you select a topic, when you choose a topic, what you need to remember while case writing is that particular topic on which I am writing the case will survive for a number of years. Kitne saal tak wo survive karega? Kyunki how many years it will survive? Because it is that particular organization, it is that particular company, it is that particular topic, it is that particular area. Whether 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, 7 years down the line, also that will be relevant. That will not become irrelevant. Jaise time pass hoga, as and when the time will go on, the topic will not become a faded topic. The topic will still be afresh. And that is what we mean by the fresh topic. So your topic should always be. So in my whiteboard, when I wrote the topic, you can see here, when I wrote the topic, analysis of financial statement is my topic. So you can see when I'm saying analysis of financial statement is my topic, that means this analysis of financial statement kabhi bhi old topic nahi hoga. It will never become a history. In any particular year, if somebody will pick that, analysis of financial statement will remain to be a fresh topic always. That is what we mean by fresh topic. I hope I'm able to explain this particular concept of fresh topic. Any questions? Right. Now this is a general question. Question number four is a general question which you are seeing on my screen. What type of case you will write? Whether you will write a decision focus case, whether you will write a compare or contrast case, whether you will write a demonstration case, whether you will write an implementation case, whether you will write a case series, whether you will write a quantitative case, whether you write a mini case for specific applications, examples of a particular issue, or whether you will write a summary or exam case. Now, for me, ye bahut jyada relevant nahi hai. For me, this is not of much importance, but yes, surely you can think of this. Now, why? What do we mean by this? Any? I will be discussing each of this. So decision focus case, where you want a particular decision to be taken, closed ended case basically.
Vinay sir, yes sir. Participants, there is some technical glitch. So we will be, as it is a break time of, it's a tea break time. So we will be